everyone. My name is Dae-Hyeong Kim from Seoul National University. And today I will talk about sweat-based glucose sensing and transdermal drug delivery. Let me first briefly introduce diabetes. Diabetes is caused by high glucose concentration in the blood, which is called as hyperglycemia. That high glucose concentration causes chronic diseases such as cardiovascular diseases, stroke, numbness, kidney problems. Therefore, it is very important to decrease that high glucose concentration by using appropriate medication, such as insulin or metformin. However, if that medication is too much, then too low glucose concentration, which is called as hypoglycemia, can happen. And this hypoglycemia can lead to tragic result, such as shock or death. Therefore, it is very important to prevent both hyperglycemia and hypoglycemia while maintaining the glucose level near homeostatic level. And to achieve that goal, patients typically use blood-based glucose sensing. Patients use finger pricking method to collect blood sample and put that blood sample on the disposable strip and insert that disposable strip into the hardware to electrochemically analyze the blood sample and estimate the blood glucose concentration. After finding out the blood glucose concentration, the patient can take medication such as an insulin shot. But as you may expect, these two procedures are quite painful and stressful. And there are a lot of children who are suffering from type 1 diabetes, and those young patients have a lot of fear in doing these two procedures. Therefore, there is a huge need to develop a painless, stress-free, and accurate glucose monitoring method, hopefully integrated with automatic painless drug delivery system. And we wanted to achieve this goal by using our wearable device technology. To remove that blood collection procedure, we focused on sweat. The good news is that sweat contains glucose, and the sweat glucose concentration has a quite good correlation with blood glucose concentration. However, there are challenges. The first challenge is in sensitivity. The sweat glucose concentration is much lower, almost 100 times lower than the blood glucose concentration, which means we need very good sensor with high sensitivity. And we solved this issue with nanotechnology. The second challenge is in accuracy. Most of glucose sensors are using glucose oxidase. So glucose sensors approaches to glucose oxidase, then the glucose molecules will be converted into gluconic acid and hydrogen peroxide. In turn, electrons will be generated. And the glucose sensor is measuring these generated electrons. So for example, if the glucose concentration is high, then high current will flow in the glucose sensor. If the glucose concentration in the bloodstream is low, then the small current will flow in the glucose sensor. Very straightforward. But the problem is that the glucose oxidase, an enzyme, also a very important factor in the glucose sensing, will be affected by environmental factors such as sweat pH, temperature, and even humidity. Therefore, to enhance accuracy, we need very good glucose sensor as well as humidity sensor, pH sensor, and temperature sensor, hopefully as a form of an integrated system. The third challenge is in deformability. We need to collect sweat efficiently and also analyze sweat accurately to estimate the glucose concentration without an error on soft skin. So the ideal form of the device is like a patch. So patch-like device can be attached on the skin, efficiently collect sweat, analyze sweat accurately. That means that we need novel device technology, such as flexible and stretchable device technology. The last challenge is in fast but painless drug delivery. We need to deliver drug to control high glucose concentration, but that should be fast and painless. We want to deliver drug rapidly because blood glucose concentration can be changed very rapidly. Within an hour, it can be increased a lot or decreased a lot. And insulin shot is a very good method to deliver insulin rapidly, but it is painful. Instead, we may use a transdermal drug delivery patch. It is painless. However, it is slow. So to solve this issue, we chose transdermal drug delivery system integrated with microneedles. And to solve these challenges and to achieve these goals, we developed a new integrated patch system. We could achieve high sensitivity by using nanoparticles. Each nanoparticle has a tiny size. However, if we combine all surface areas of nanoparticles, then the entire surface area will be massive, which will maximize the sensitivity of the glucose sensor. For deformable sensors, we used graphene. Graphene is ultra-thin, highly conductive, soft, and even stretchy. We can easily make graphene into various kinds of sensors in an array form. And the integrated sensor array based on graphene, after attached on the skin, it maintains very good performance, even under wrinkled state. To enhance accuracy, we used multiple different kinds of sensors. We used, of course, glucose sensor, as well as pH sensor, temperature sensor, humidity sensor, even strain gauge to maximize the accuracy. After figuring out the exact glucose concentration, we need to control the high glucose concentration by delivering appropriate amount of drug painlessly and rapidly. And to achieve that goal, we used microneedles. And to control the drug delivery through microneedles, we used ultra-thin heater underneath the microneedle patch. The patch system is connected to a portable electrochemical analyzer, which has a LCD touch interface. It supplies power to the patch. Also, it collects data and wirelessly transfers the data to user's smartphone. When the patch is laminated on the skin, sweat will be generated. At first, there is a warm-up period. At some point, the sweat begins to be generated, and the humidity sensor monitors the sweat generation process. And when the relative humidity inside the patch reaches 80%, we begin the measurement by using other sensors. We measure glucose as well as pH and temperature simultaneously. It's because glucose oxidase, an enzyme, can be affected by environmental factors like sweat pH and temperature. For example, these two graphs show calibration curves of glucose sensors. As I mentioned, the glucose sensor is measuring current. So by measuring current, we can estimate glucose concentration. The problem is that the calibration curve can be changed depending on the sweat pH and temperature. So only when we measure glucose simultaneously with sweat pH and temperature, we can enhance the accuracy of the glucose measurement. We applied this patch system to human subject. We monitored glucose concentration change over a day from 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. In this graph, there are three data sets. The blue data set corresponds to blood glucose concentration measured by a commercial glucose meter. There are two red data sets, which correspond to sweat glucose concentrations, one measured by our glucose diabetes patch, the other measured by commercial glucose assay. And as you can see, these two sweat glucose concentrations match very well. And more importantly, the changing trend of blood glucose concentration matches very well with the changing trend of sweat glucose concentration. For example, after meal, after breakfast, after lunch, after dinner, the glucose concentration rapidly increases. As time goes, the glucose concentration slowly decreases. And more recently, we developed a disposable type sweat-based glucose sensing strip. The advantage of this design is that we can miniaturize the sensor size, which means we can minimize the required amount of sweat, which will shorten the sweat generation time and which will accelerate the overall measurement process. This movie shows how the wearable patch and the disposable strip work for sweat-based glucose sensing. The patch can be attached on the skin. Typically, we add additional encapsulation film to prevent unwanted evaporation of generated sweat. We typically use exercise to generate sweat, such as cycling, jogging, or running. And humidity sensor monitors the sweat generation process. And in case of disposable strip, there is a microfluidic channel which can uptake the generated sweat through the microfluidic channel, and the miniaturized sensors will analyze the sweat to estimate glucose concentration as well as pH and temperature. After finding out the accurate glucose concentration, we can control the high glucose concentration by delivering drugs. And we used microneedles. Microneedle is a kind of needle, so the drug injection speed is very fast. But the scale, the size of needle is in microscale. The height is 700 micron. The width is only 150 micron. So even after it is attached on the skin, it is painless. The microneedle is made of biodegradable polymer mixed with drugs. So when the microneedles are contacted with biofluids, such as interstitial fluid in the skin, then the microneedles will be dissolved away and the drugs mixed in the microneedle will be injected into the bloodstream. But to control this drug delivery, we intentionally coated the surface of the microneedle with hydrophobic protective coating layer. So in normal condition, the needle will not be dissolved. However, if we turn on the heater underneath the microneedles, because of the thermal actuation, the hydrophobic coating layer can be melted away. Then the microneedles will be exposed to the interstitial fluid. When the microneedles are contacted with interstitial fluid in the skin, then the needles will be dissolved, and the drugs contained in the microneedles will be rapidly injected into the bloodstream. We tested this transdermal patch by using a diabetic mouse. We first shaved the fur and then attached the microneedle patch on the belly. When we observed the skin surface of the belly, we could observe quite good pores, micropores, of course, made by the microneedles. And when we turned on the thermal actuator, because of the thermal actuation, the protective coating layer could be melted away. Then the microneedles will be contacted with interstitial fluid inside the skin. So the needles will be dissolved, and the drugs contained in the needles will be rapidly injected into the bloodstream. So we could successfully decrease the blood glucose concentration. So in conclusion, we wanted to help diabetic patients. Therefore, we developed a painless, stress-free, and autonomic closed glucose management system by using our wearable device technology. Thank you for your attention.